to another exciting edition of Explore Richland. I'm Mark Ingham. Well, have you ever wondered how public art installations find their way into our city? Who's making the decisions about what and where? You know, in Richland, we have art all over the place. It's in our city facilities, it's in our parks, it's in our shopping districts, and now it's popping up in our roundabouts. You know, public art provides economic benefit and enhances our city's image. Now, to talk about the state of art in Richland, we are thrilled to welcome Jeff Kissel to the program. Jeff is the chair of the Richland Arts Commission. Jeff, thanks so much for joining us today.
Good morning. Thank you.
You bet. Now, we're excited to talk about specific art installations that are popping up in town, but we feel a great place to start this interview is to have you inform us about the Richland Arts Commission. So talk to us about the Richland Arts Commission and what are some of your goals?
Sure. The Richland Arts Commission is one of the many city's all-volunteer commissions.
Right.
We specifically are here to promote, facilitate, and enhance the city's activities that are related to art. We are informed by the City Council and the public at large and work closely with city staff to bring as much as we can to the city's arts activities.
Well, that's great. Well, on behalf of the city, I'd like to thank you for volunteering your time and offering your services to the city of Richland and its residents. Now, Jeff, the art installations we brought you on specifically to talk about are being installed along the Dupertail corridor and more specifically in the roundabouts. You know, why do roundabouts make such an ideal location for public art?
Well, Mark, when the city constructs new roundabouts and any new public works projects, we're actually trying to focus on low maintenance, high sustainability stuff. Mm. And when you install a piece of art, not only do you get a beautiful piece of imagery to represent the city and the culture of art, you also get a piece of architecture that is at a fraction of the cost as far as long-term maintenance goes with respect to traditional plant-based filling.
And we have four roundabouts in the new Dupertail corridor. Can you explain the artwork that is going in at each roundabout?
Sure. So we have four new roundabouts, and there are two, they come in pairs. There are two roundabouts on the north side of the Yakima River, and then two here on the south side of the Yakima River. The two on the north side are actually in an area that used to be a hub of electrical and concrete and metal workers and other skilled labor there. We wanted to honor that heritage by building two sets of sculptures that had the raw look of metal associated with it, representing the growth of the new boomtown. So in the Thayer roundabout, there is a bulb that represents the growing city, and it has a Cortan metal finish that has a very rustic look that is an homage to history. In the right roundabout, there are two sculptures, one with that same Cortan metal finish, another with a bright stainless steel. And these are to represent the new change coming in through the city, while still having that same sense of movement as you're going around the roundabout. On the south side, where we are here today, we wanted to call for art that represented Richland today. A web of interconnected, symbiotic dichotomies thriving together. Agriculture paired with cutting-edge technology and science, harnessing the bounty of our surrounding natural resources while understanding modern sustainability. A city with deep roots beginning to reimagine itself in the modern age. These concepts we gave to the artists, Riza A plus D, who took these ideas and created a pair of pieces that you see here today. At 182, off in the distance, the waves of viticulture honors our three rivers with a generic wave-like shape, while at the same time having the profile of grape leaves stretched out to look like rows of grapevines at the many local vineyards. Off Columbia Park Trail, where we are right now, we see a giant net-like structure with fish inside, honoring fish as our local resource for food and sport, while at the same time doubling as a distortion in space-time during the collision of two swirling black holes, regularly observed by our local observatory, LIGO.
Oh, nice.
So we've done our best at the Richland Arts Commission to connect the various themes and ideas present in our home. From the past, present, and future, we hope these sculptures will make you proud to be a resident of Richland.
Wow, you bet. They're beautiful. I was here when they were installing them, and it was definitely an exciting day. And you mentioned the theme of connecting Richland, and a big piece of connecting Richland is the Dupertail Bridge. and you also have your hands with artwork that is going to be appearing on the Jupiter Bridge. Can you talk a little bit about the artwork that's going on the bridge?
Sure, absolutely. So there are several pieces of art on the Jupiter Bridge corridor. The first is the sound wall that is on the south side of the Yakima, and that's meant to represent a rolling hillscape that you see in the surrounding area with mountains like Badger Mountain and Rattlesnake Mountain. And underneath the bridge, when you stand on the boat launch on the north side of the river, you'll be able to see a rising sun underneath the bridge on the retaining wall down there, where the sun is a typical thing that represents Richland.
That's great. I wanted to ask you about this, the process of selecting art for specific locations. Can you talk a little bit about how art is selected for the roundabouts?
Sure. So we in the Arts Commission have subcommittees that are we assign to various projects and tasks that city staff provide for us. And though the budget is coming into those subcommittees as a predetermined thing, so we have to work within the confines of our budget. We are always gracious when the city offers us opportunities. For the Thayer and Wright roundabouts, we had a smaller budget to work with because the roundabouts themselves involved a lot less infrastructure change. But we are actually a tiny fraction of the budget of the overall public works project.
And you know, an interesting thing I think about the roundabouts and just the look of the roundabouts is not just the art pieces, but the surrounding, you know, area. And, you know, the roundabouts at Thayer and Wright, they feature, you know, really nice landscaping. Right now we have this beautiful rock. Do you guys have your hands in the design of the whole roundabouts?
We do. So we work closely with the artists. In these roundabouts in the Queensgate area, we were actually working interactively and iteratively with the artists. For this one in particular, the surrounding rocks are actually representative of waves that are emanating from the gravitational field of the black holes that represented in this imagery.
Wow, well, you guys do a great job. I mean, they look beautiful. I wanted to ask you a question. How does the Arts Commission, you know, work with the city of Richland? Like, what does that relationship look like?
We meet with the city staff every first Wednesday of the month and every third Wednesday of the month. And in those meetings, we gather for about an hour and talk about the various projects that are on our work plan. We work annually to create a work plan to have a guide for what we're doing throughout the year, where we reference public works projects and other performing arts activities throughout the city, and work and advise the city staff and city council on how to work through those and provide interesting art opportunities in those things. The city council has been very gracious with us and giving us lots of opportunities, and these opportunities are continuing to increase and grow, and I hope we have satisfied their need.
And that's exciting. Well said, Jeff. Thanks so much for coming on the program and talking to us about art, and specifically the arts popping up in roundabouts around town. And we did mention the Jupiter Bridge, and if you would like more information on the Jupiter Bridge, you can find it on the city's webpage at the link below. And don't forget, we are where you are. Find the city of Richland on all the popular social media platforms. Find us on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram. I'm Mark Ingham. Thanks for joining me on this edition of Explore Richland.